IT and ITES industry in India has today become a growth engine for the economy, contributing substantially to increase the GDP, urban employment and exports to achieve the vision of a very powerful and resilient India. Well, the Indian economy has been impacted by the global slowdown, but the IT and ITES industry has displayed resilience and tenacity in countering the unpredictable conditions and reiterating the viability of India's fundamental value proposition. The Indian IT sector, which exhibited sterling performance over the last 4 or 5 years, is now facing tough times, but there is nothing fundamentally wrong with the sector, and the future really holds the promise. The purple patch of the Indian IT and other services sector has somewhat faded in recent months. Since last year, the industry has been facing a lot of adversities. The global recession, economic downturn, subprime mortgage crisis, and the domestic factors such as the rupee appreciation and inflation have adversely impacted the Indian IT sector. As the industry moved into 2008, these unpleasant factors strengthened further, and the IT industry during the whole year has faced huge enigma in managing business, as there were huge employee and wage cuts, and many companies have started shifting their focus to other nations also. It has certainly not been a great year for the Indian IT industry. A gamut of factors has contributed to its lackluster show. Of course, the rupee gaining against the US dollar has largely affected the sector. Nearly 3/5 of the domestic IT revenues are generated from exports, and rupee's rise has made Indian exports expensive in the foreign market. Apart from the appreciating rupee, the sinking financial market in the US, which is a major market for Indian IT products, is adding to the woes of IT companies. In fact, the slowdown in US has affected not only the IT industry, but also other sectors, such as real estate, manufacturing, banking, and housing also. And let me come to some of the key highlights of the Indian IT sector for the financial year 2009, which are the export revenues are estimated to gross. The export revenues are estimated to gross around 47.3 billion, accounting for 66% of the total IT/ITES industry revenues. And domestic market continued to gain momentum, growing at 26% in INR terms, and account of the overall positive economic climate, increased adoption of technology and outsourcing. And engineering services and software products exports increased by 29%. Direct employment reached nearly 2 million, with 1.5 million in the export segment, year-on-year increase of 36% in 2008. The indirect employment multiplier suggested that the industry created between 6 to 8 million additional jobs. UK and US together constituted 79% of the global exports in financial year 2008, thereby dominating the export markets as such. Of course, I have two, three slides to show it to you. And of course, it gives you a overall picture about the industry growth. And of course, it's very much available to the authorities, and probably the learned delegates can go through it later on. And of course, the 16 industrial sectors and their progress, and also some of them are in negative growth, and some of them are creating great ambitions for the Indian economy, and et cetera, et cetera. And of course, we have many other things to say about the impact on Indian economy, but I'm sure that the measures really taken by the Indian government is something, of course, rememberable. Probably these are also very much available with the authorities as such. And measures, of course, nearly to boost investment and spending, revive growth, the RBI cut the rates which it charges on short-term loans on banks, and 6.5% to 5.5%, and also reduce the cash reserve ratio, the share of deposit which has to be kept with the RBI, from 5.5% to 5%. Likewise, of course, we have certain measures have been taken up by the Indian government to to revive the exports, right? And to boost infrastructure in India, infrastructure finance company limited has been allowed to rise almost 30,000 crores from tax-free bonds, and also to make more funds available, ceiling on foreign institutional investments in corporate bonds have been increased to 15 billion from 6 billion. And of course, slashing down the excess duty and the cement prices locally drop while steel prices may cost less per ton. A small relief package of 325 crores for leather textiles and gems and jewelry. Reduction of service taxes almost 2%. A 2% reduction in service tax will definitely touch 500 million persons to entire stimulus package of rupees 30,000 crores. Yeah. Let me conclude by saying that way back in 1936, Keynes had highlighted the role of animal spirit even in human beings. That I need not elaborate it as such. It focuses on how human psychology drives the economy. It highlights the role of non-economic motives in explaining the crisis, and much of the prosperity in market economies has been possible because of this animal spirit, and regulation should not suppress animal spirit. The excess in the financial system often creates a natural process of creative restriction, from prices to ensure a forced cleanup, it is very essential to clean up the system for that matter. And a stable financial system has to be ensured for better sustainable growth and economic development. Regulatory and supervisory architectures in the process of evolution of financial systems help in preventing crisis. When unsound practices lead to crisis, the creative destruction process makes the systems to recover from the crisis. The global crisis has offered the opportunity to revisit the conventional wisdom in many areas. Future approach to financial sector reforms must be guided with the primary objective of making the financial sector to serve the needs of the real economy. And one should take advantage of the opportunities unleashed in various sectors and move towards the direction of inclusive growth. Ladies and gentlemen, it is, of course, the central authorities or the government authorities in India, of course, have sought the clear-cut cooperation, coordination, and conciliation. So in between various sectors to develop the sustainable strategies. So it's very important at this particular time of global recession, and I'm sure that the most hot areas so will quickly come back and make the economy once again colorful. Thank you very much for the okay.
Thank you, Dr. Raju.